Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Ya, it's nice to see you, Bapak Ibu, all English teachers of SMK and SMA in Bondowoso and Situbondo. Today, Friday, the 5th of February 2021. Okay. Our Zoom meeting today is about the explanation and description of speaking assessment 2021 of tourism promotion, culinary, and current issue for our students' flock. So, first of all, I would like to extend my sincere gratitude to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala so that we are able to join this Zoom meeting with our best condition. Salawat and salam we always deliver to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I would like to also say my big thanks to all English teachers for joining this Zoom meeting. Today I, Pak Febri and Bu Holif are going to share with you the aspects to be assessed in the students' performance in speaking every Tuesday and Thursday for Sibon Speak Up program. For further information, would you please, Bapak Febri, explain and describe the assessment process? Time and place are yours.
Okay, thank you, Mrs. Ellie, for the time given. Good afternoon, everybody. How are you today? Okay. Right now, I would like to explain about the assessment of student speaking skill. I would like to share my screen. Can I share my screen, Mrs. Ellie?
Yes, please, Baba. Share with us.
There is a in my screen now there is a writing that host disabled participant screen sharing. I need the allowance of the house.
Oh yeah. Okay. Yeah, Bapak, you are the host now.
Okay.
You are the host now. Yeah.
Assalamualaikum, Febri Silau ya.
Waalaikumsalam.
Bentar saya tutup Silau.
Can you see my screen now?
Ya, Bapak.
Okay, yes,
yeah,
yes,
I can see you. Yeah.
Okay. Can I start now?
Yes.
Yes. How many participants? Okay. Wait a minute. Now it's only 18 participants.
Yes, ma'am. We have okay, 18 participants today.
Please inform the groups of vocational school English teacher to join. I will inform to vocational SMA teacher to join this.
Yeah.
SMA English teacher. I will take a picture first.
Okay, shall we continue this explanation of the assessment form of student speaking skill?
Yes, sure, Bapak.
Okay, thank you very much to all teachers that have joined with us today. And today I'm going to
silakan join, Bapak, Ibu,
explain as clear as I can about this assessment of student speaking skill. So there are some questions when you click the link of this assessment that I will share later in our groups. Number one is there's a question's name of student assessed. It means that you have to fill this out, the name of student you are being assessed. Nama siswa yang nanti akan dinilai. And then that's the question number one. And then number two, the school of student access, it means that where the students study, asal sekolah. And then that's number two. This is a very simple one. And then number three is name of assessor. It means that we are, as a teacher, that will be the assessor of the students being performed. And then,
excuse me, Pak Febri. Name of, yes. Excuse me, Pak Febri. May I sorry. For the name of the assessor here is the educator. The name of the educator, because when the students present, there must be the edu. Yeah. Maybe you change to be the educator or no problem.
Okay, then. Okay. So we will change it, Mrs. Olivia.
Yes,
assessor became educator.
Yes.
Okay, thank you for the. And then that's number three, and then it's number four, the school of educator.
Aduh, mau perjalanan jauh.
Number one until number four, we have to write down because this is an essay. And now we at number five questions. Number five. This is a multiple choice that you have to pick one, which one is the most appropriate to the student performer. There is an item about this. First is about fluency. Confidently, this is the first choice. Confidently and naturally, it's 3 points, and hesitate several times, 2 points, many hesitations and great difficulty, 1 point. This is student speaking performance at fluency. You have to pick one. And then number five, number six, student speaking performance pronunciation, pengucapannya, the highest point, 3 point, is very accurate. Choice B, sometimes have incorrect inflection, to 2 points. Jadi ini maksudnya ada pengucapan yang berubah-ubah seperti itu. Kemudian, and then the last choice, very hard to understand. This is only 1 point. This is from aspects pronunciation. And then student speaking performance, grammar. Grammar. Students with a good grammar, no more incorrect grammar than native speaker, it means like native speaker, they will get 3 points. This is the choose number one. And the second is occasionally used inappropriate or incorrectly tenses and part of speech, they will get 2 points. Jadi ada penggunaan tenses atau part of speech yang kurang sesuai. And then the lowest point, only 1 point, frequent uses inappropriate or incorrectly tenses and part of speech. That's the grammar. And then we continue to the vocabulary, student speaking performance at vocabulary. They will get the highest point, 3 points, if their vocabulary is sufficient to be understood. And the second choice is moderate, 2 points. And the lowest point, 1 point, only 1 point, the vocabulary they use is very limited. That's the from the aspect of vocabulary. And then we continue to student speaking performance contents. They will get a higher score if they knowledgeable and detailed in showing their vlogs, video tourisms. And they will get 2 points if they are aware of the subjects, and they get the lowest point, only 1 point, if they are little understanding of the subject. That's the from the aspect of content. And then student speaking performance creativity, they will get 3 points if they are exceptional original material and interpretations. And they will get 2 points if little originality and interpretation. And they will get 1 point if they are repetitive and no variety. That's the creativity. So we try to make assessment from every aspect. And then student speaking performance from eye context, body and voice, they will get high score, 3 points, if speaker keep eye contact and speak clearly all the time. They will get 2 points if speaker read notes occasionally, sometimes they will read notes and speak clearly most. And they will get the lowest point, only 1 point, if speaker read notes and speak unclear. For the last item, and this assessment, there is a suggestion from Mrs. Halif at Mrs. Dede a few days ago that student performance should be assessed carefully in a good way. Sometime they will perform real flock, or sometime they just perform PowerPoint flocks. So we have to differentiate this because the effort they do is not the same with the others. Jadi maksudnya yang lebih mudah begini. Jadi untuk usaha itu, karena nanti ada siswa atau sekolah yang menampilkan real vlog di lokasi. Ada yang seperti itu, tapi juga ada yang menampilkan hanya berupa gambar atau foto-foto atau PowerPoint. Nah, ini harus dibedakan juga. Jadi ini tambahan dari Mrs. Halif and Mrs. Dede. Jadi nanti for student they will get the highest point if 3 points if they perform the real vlogs on the location, they will get outstanding achieve, and they will get 2 points if sufficiently achieve, and they will get the lowest point, 1 point only, if the vlogs it needs improvement. So which there are 12 questions on this assessment student speaking skill, and I hope and we hope it will be adequate to every teacher who are going to be the educator later on next week, Tuesday or Thursday. I think this is that I can explain to you for the moment. At the moment, maybe there are some questions about this, and we will share this link after this, after we have done this meeting. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam.
Thank you, Pak Febri. Sorry. I think everything is quite clear in here, but I just remember one thing, and maybe we have to discuss it. This there isn't the part in which for the assessment that is about the questions, because the AJU will ask the questions to the participants, I mean to the presenter. Maybe if it is too much, we can skip sums, and because this is a telling story or speaking competence, so there must be the real communication. I mean, the AJU will ask one or two questions, and maybe the question is not come from the AJU, it can be from the participants, I mean the audiences, it can be from the students, or it can be from the observers, and it can be from the AJU. If the student have make a questions, then the AJU, I think it's not necessary to ask the questions. How then they answer the question, there must be the point. This is from my opinion. We need another opinion from the other teacher, because this is it is not finished yet. So we make it clear all the things. And in my opinion, there must be one part in which it's so the student's competence, because there is a video and then they present it. Do you think it is enough, or do you think it must be added by the questions from the AJU? In my opinion, it must be added by the question from the AJU, but we need another opinions from the other teachers. Yeah. Maybe for this, for wearing, check it one by one. I mean, from the top, Mr. Febri, Pak Febri, yeah, we check it again. From okay, next. It is clear. Okay, student speaking performance, conventional and naturally. Okay, this is good. Pronunciation, okay. Next, performance, grammar. Well, how about if we... What do you think? Next, we have a look again after the vocabulary. Content, performance, yes, come to the performance. Knowledge, ability, and details. Maybe the question, it can be put here. If yeah. they can answer all the questions. Yeah, do you think so, yeah. Bu Eli? If they can answer all the questions, mean we give it 3 points.
Yeah, I agree.
What do you think?
Yeah, ma'am. Okay, I agree with you, Ms. Olive.
Yeah,
I agree.
Belong to the
yes. Okay. I think it okay. belongs to mm-hmm. aspect of content if they yeah. they answer the question of educator.
Okay, clear. So when there is a questions from the AJU or from the students, they are able yeah. to answer. They really understand about the question and they are able to answer the question. Then we give it 3 points, right?
Yeah.
Okay. It's clear. This mm-hmm. is very good, Pak Febri. This is very good assessment. So maybe we have to put student speaking performance for the content on the below side, Bapak. So after we assess all items.
Sorry,
please scroll up. Scroll up. Stop. Yeah. So for the content, maybe we have to put it on the below side of ini.
As the last question.
The layout. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because this is a very detailed assessment. Everything make it very clear. It is clear, Pak Febri make it very clear. But yeah, one thing that is about how the student answer mean that really they really understand about the contents that what they are performing. So all the okay. teacher must have the same understanding okay. about it. Yes.
Okay. I have observed about the assessment made by Mr. Febri. Okay.
Yes.
As you say that it is very good, but don't we try to think again about? I think that it is so intricate assessment. How about if we try to make a simple assessment? Because we just in the beginning, you know, that we just in the beginning, it is the first of this program. So don't try to make it so complicated, but make it easier, simple. Mm-hmm. I think that the assessment is so not like 10 assessment, 10 point, but we try to make until 5, yeah? That is only my suggestion. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that it is so intricate.
Yeah, I know, this is Bu Nona, I also think this is very details, and yeah. This is good, this is very good, but it make take much time for the AJU to think it very carefully.
Okay, we just busy in the assessment. Actually, we want to observe about the student competence when they want to deliver something, the product, yeah, but if we the assessment made me confused automatically, yeah, there will be not a good impact to our students.
Okay, maybe
that
we have
why
to
try yeah, to make is... a short, easy yeah. for the assessment, not until 10, but just 5, I think it is enough.
Okay.
Yeah, that is okay. my suggestion.
If we want to delve, if we want to skip some of the aspect, but still all the thing must be contents of matter, manner, and method. The three of it, yeah. there must be in this point. So maybe we try to revise together. We see it from the very beginning after the AJU. For the, is it right, Pak Febri? For the student's name, for the school name, it is very clear. We come focus on the part of the speaking that we are going to discuss first. Have a look on the fluency all together.
Okay. Excuse me, Mrs. Halif.
Yes.
For the student speaking performance assessment, let me make it clear. It is not more than 10 questions. It's only 8 questions. Fluency number one, pronunciation number two, grammar number three, vocabulary number four, creativity number five, eye contact number six, effort number seven, content number eight.
Okay.
Only eight questions for the multiple choice.
Yeah. How about this? How about if we, I think because they are guidance by their teacher, we believe that the grammar is already correct. How about if we skip the grammar?
Okay. Good.
We skip it, the grammar.
I want opinion.
They made a mistake about the grammar, just so that's okay.
I want opinion with you.
What about dialect?
Okay, should we erase these questions for grammar?
Yeah. Because I'm afraid if they made a mistake about the grammar
about
and too much about the grammar, they will be afraid to speak for the next time.
Okay. I will erase it. So it means there are 7 questions now.
Yeah, 7 questions. We check it again.
7 questions.
Which? Yes, where were we? Sorry, because I use a Zoom, so I have to close and come and go and okay. Tadi ended automatically. Okay. Yeah. So, how then, Pak Febri? Yeah, the other teacher. Ellie, where are you? Yeah. The same with me, Mr. Pak Febri. We just go and then come again.
Meet again. So, do we have to meet the others, Mrs. Salif?
Yeah, for me, for grammar, we just skip it, the grammar. And then we have a look again. There will be seven. There will be seven items that will be assisted by the EJU. Is it right?
There are seven questions for seven the educator.
Yeah. Silakan Bapak Ibu. Maybe you have another opinions, or do you think it is enough? If it is enough, then Pak Febri will tell it again. So we got the same understanding about this. Then we can share to our friends.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
Yes, Pak Andi.
If I may come up with one suggestion, we can combine the aspects of fluency and vocabulary all together, because the two aspects of there are in harmony in terms of the way students are speaking.
Okay. We have a look. Kita lihat coba Pak Febri. Fluency and vocabulary become one item.
I mean fluency and pronunciation, ma'am.
Oh, not vocabulary. Yeah. Yeah, I think
fluency
so.
Fluency and pronunciation.
Yeah.
You fluency can combine all together the two aspects, the two first aspects of there, fluency and pronunciation, because they are quite the same in terms of they are speaking and delivering their story.
So it must be like what? If we combine student performance in here, fluency and pronunciations. So what are the indicators? Maybe confident? Confident and accurate become together or something like what?
Yeah, it can be accuracy.
Accuracy.
Accuracy. Maybe other teachers have another opinion.
Maybe accuracy and confidence.
Accuracy.
Accuracy and confidence.
Yes, ma'am.
Accuracy.
Confidence belong to the performance, okay?
Yeah.
And then accuracy become to the fluency and pronunciation. What do you think?
Yes, ma'am.
What about dialect?
Accuracy and confidently. Accuracy belong to fluency in this year, pronunciation and fluency, and then confidently, that's belong to performance. Kalau begitu bagaimana Bapak Ibu? What do you think?
What about dialect?
It's okay.
Yeah. Maybe we can combine the indicators. If we have to combine these two items, so we have to combine the indicators too. So maybe it will be like this: confident and accurate, and then hesitate and incorrect inflections. Maybe.
Accuracy. Actually, with naturally, this is the same. If the accuracy right, then they speak very naturally.
Yeah. So we have to combine confident and accurate, maybe.
Okay.
Yeah. For the indicators. For the indicators. Confident, confident and accurate. Yeah, like this one.
I think so. I agree with you. How about the other teacher?
What okay. One opinion with you.
So maybe we have to add there. Fluency belong fluency and pronunciation.
Fluency and pronunciation.
Let's keep it separate. Okay. So and then the second point two
indicators, yeah.
Hello.
Hesitates and
hello.
Inflections. Hesitates and inflections.
Hello.
Like this. Has stated several times and have incorrect inflection. What inflection?
Inflections mean if there is a student say one word, then at another time he will pronounce different. So, unstable in pronouncing word.
Jadi ini ragu salah pengucapan seperti itu.
Iya.
Jadi anaknya sekaligus ragu-ragu, sekaligus salah pengucapannya.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Inflection. Yeah. Okay. Agreed.
For the third indicators, many hesitation and good difficulty. It is a very hard to understand. I think, it's the same. Yeah. Many hesitations and hard to understand. How about this?
Yeah, combining.
Many hesitations and hard to understand.
Okay. Like this, Mrs. Ellie?
I think so,
Papa. Together will be how many? Yeah. Good.
So we have to erase this question.
Sorry, Bu Ellie. Yes. Apa brief? Yeah. I think the third indicator same with the second one. Hesitate? What is the meaning hesitation? Same meaning.
Yeah, tapi
is it right?
Untuk
hesitation and hesitate.
Yeah, ibu. Yeah. Maybe it's hard to understand. Maybe we just it's hard to understand.
Keraguannya hanya beberapa saja, tapi kalau yang poinnya dapat satu,
lalu ragu.
Udah nggak berani ngomong, udah nggak bisa ngomong, ya hesitation, hard to understand, seperti itu saya kira.
Iya.
Yeah. Pronunciations and fluency though.
Maybe that's right. Pak Febri, Bu Eli, and all the teacher, memang ini agak hampir sama poin kedua dan poin ketiga ya. Mungkin maybe we have to make it clear for the third part. Karena satu poin, it really means for the student. It means something for the students. Hesitated several time and have incorrect inflection, it is clear. The third point, many hesitation, this is almost the same. Yeah, the meaning is the same actually with hesitated several time. Mungkin kita clearkan the third part.
Think like this, Miss. This is solid. Hesitated all the time.
Hesitated all the time,
like this.
Yeah. Like this. All the time. Or maybe it's hard to be.
What about that?
Hesitated all the time.
Yeah, I agree. The other teacher. Kalau saya sih sudah setuju karena ini anak kan ada yang kalau mau ngomong tuh ada yang stuck, ada yang sangat nggak bisa ngomong udah gitu. Nah, kalau stuck masih di sini di poin yang 2 points, kalau yang tidak bisa mengungkapkan sudah idenya itu dapat 1 poin. Mungkin seperti itu.
Okay. I agree with you. Deal, Miss Ali.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Bu Eli, some yes, of our friends cannot join because this is free. So sometimes they just in and then automatically they out of the meeting. After we discuss all and all of the teacher here agreed, then Pak Febri will share this to all the teacher that belong to Kampung Bahasa. So all the teacher will, this is as the guidance for the teacher to guide the students to prepare about the storytelling that will be present by the students.
Yeah.
Karena beberapa nggak bisa masuk gitu ya Bapak Ibu ya. Okay, that's right.
Febri, don't forget what to, else? Oh ya, sudah. Well done, thank you. Adjudicators.
Okay, we check it one by one, Bu Eli, from the very top.
Please scroll up, Bapak. Scroll up. Would you please, Bapak Ibu, all teachers who join this Zoom meeting today, please pay attention to our assessment form
for the student.
Yeah, student name of student assessed, name of school of student assessed. I think it's clear. Name of adjudicator, school of adjudicator.
Yeah, excuse me. Why the educator must be send their name here, write it on the name here, because all the edu will get the certificate from Siamio. That is why they have to write it on the names. Sehingga nanti di akhir, it is difficult for us as a coordinator because all the edu, they have already listed the name correctly and we will send to Mr. Gatot and they will got the certificate. And it can be used in, what is that, SKP. Bisa kita masukkan ke SKP ya. Nanti bunyinya itu sebagai penghargaan as the edu.
Ms. Alif, Ms. Alif. Yes. I'm sorry. I would like to ask about what is the difference between name of adjudicator here with school adjudicator?
The school is their institution.
Institution, and who is the first slave? The professionally name of adjudicator.
Yeah, for example, when SMKPP choose the EJU Bu Arista, then after that Bu Arista write it on the school of educator SMK Vocational School of SMKPP, like that.
Okay, for the for example, me name of educator Arista, and the second one, the school educator.
Your institution, ma'am. Your institution.
Where do you teach? Where do you teach?
Is it better for us to write institution?
The institution, maybe.
Institution.
Oh yeah, I see. Yeah,
institution.
Yeah.
The so institution. Because I'm very confused with how to differentiate to.
Yeah, maybe we take that from UNESA, from UNUD, UNED, okay, institution, the EJU institution, I think, yeah.
It's better for.
Thank you.
Right, institution of adjudicator.
Yeah. Yes, okay, next, we continue. Pak Febri.
Okay.
Fluency and pronunciation, and then vocabulary, right?
And then performance, good for exceptional origin material. Okay, in here, we have to discuss about this. Student speaking performance in this case is creativity. When they make the vlog, Bapak Ibu, this is, they make it by their own team. If they take the video, they try to make it their own, not put the video which is already exist in YouTube. For example, last meeting we see the performance from City Bondo. They choose the video which is already available in YouTube. It is not we are not allowed to give a good point if the student doing that. We really appreciate the student's effort. For example, when they want to tell about Kawa Ijen, and then they use the video of Kawa Ijen, which is already exists in YouTube, so this is not use their own creativity.
Yeah. The main point is the originality.
Yeah, I mean, we really appreciate the students' effort. Jadi effortnya yang betul-betul kita hargai, Bapak Ibu, bagaimana they make it by their own, with their team. That's how okay, and this is not only vlog. All the picture here, you may use a PPT, but of course the point will be different. And you can also use a storybook or picture as the media. It is okay, but of course one more, the point will be different, right, Pak Febri? Because there is an IT part in when they use a vlog. Kita menghargai upaya bahwa mereka mempunyai kemampuan IT yang bagus. And we really appreciate about their competence in IT skill also.
Yeah. Excuse me, ma'am. We've got a question about the point of effort from siapa tadi? Bu Lulu or maybe? What if our school doesn't have a media or supporting media to take the vlog?
I think
that PPT is okay, but maybe for it is like what my students did. Yeah, they take. The video, they take the video by their mobile phones. There are so many application for video editing, like banyak kali aplikasi untuk edit video. Jadi my students did it. They use their mobile phone to take the video for their vlog and they edit it.
I think that's okay. Gini, Bapak Ibu. In this part, bagian ini itu, kita menghargai upaya anak bahwa mereka juga punya kemampuan IT yang bagus. If they have that, nyambung dengan IT-nya, maka kita beri poin 3. Tentu EJU-nya akan tahu, oh ya, ini IT-nya bagus, dia sudah. Maka we give it 3 poin. Bagaimana? Yeah. Ada masukan yang lain, Bapak? Sorry, I drink.
In my opinion, we can use handphone manually, although we don't use video editing. We can make a video. We can make video manually using our gadgets. So if our gadgets doesn't make what is too full, overload with many using video editing. For example, my gadget is not applicative, tidak support untuk video editing, so I use it manually.
Yeah. We have to
leave. To remember. Leave.
Yeah.
As we know that last presentation conducted by our student, we know that they just use their mobile phone.
Yeah,
as you can see in Kampung Bahasa, as you can see in Kampung Bahasa, how do you see? I think that it is impressive, it is not exciting, I think. So I think it is not a problem for us if we just use video edit, yeah? Then you can see in our student last time in Kampung Bahasa, they just use his mobile phone, they say like that.
Camera, right? Using camera, video in camera, is it right, Miss Nona?
Yeah, okay, they just use it. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, Miss Holly can explain more about that.
The problem in here whether they use vlog or they use PPT or they use another.
Yeah.
What is it? If they use a very outstanding.
Outstanding.
Camera, no problem. That's belong to them. But we just see whether this is vlog, PPT, or just using a traditional media. Poinnya di situ.
Yeah. Yeah. Believe that's why I say that because it is just the beginning of our program. That's why don't make so intricate. Make it simple. You know that we are different condition. So what a pity for the suburban school, yeah. There are some handicap with their facility. That's why make it easy for them. So using vlog or PPT, I think it's okay. Yeah, don't make a burden for them. Okay. All in all, here we just want to know about how to make them to speak up and speak up. It is our first point. Yeah. Better and better day by day. We will upgrade our competence like that.
Yeah, I agree, Bu Nona. The main goal is their speaking ability, their competence in speaking. So for this is only the media. Speaking performance, we call it in here, Pak Febri, right? It don't evolve if they make in the form of vlog, we give additional mark. If they use a PPT, we also give the mark. If they use another media, we also give the mark. But of course, the mark, the point will be different because the difficulty is different. Yes. Is it so?
Yeah, I think so, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. Ya, gitu ya, Bapak Ibu ya.
Got it.
Next, okay. Pak Febri.
Okay.
We will revise after the first period. Nanti kalau sudah satu ini jalan, we got the winner, kita revisi lagi. Ya, Bapak Ibu ya, biar ini berjalan dulu ya. Okay, next, student speaking performance.
This is the last one, content.
Yeah, I think it's clear.
Febri, would you please scroll up, Febri?
Oh yeah, dah. Okay. No problem. Yeah, thank you. Pak Febri, the last one, point two. We will make it clear.
Content.
Yeah, the content acknowledgeable and details, right? Three, aware of the subject. Oh, what is that? We will make all the teacher understand about this.
Maybe the aware term. Of the term, maybe. The term, maybe. Aware of the subject.
Aware of the subject means it's in the middle. Know some things about the questions of the educator, but not to know much. Just only know, not in detail.
Begini Bapak. Bapak Ibu, aware of the subject, I think it is about the subject that they talk about. Jadi misalnya ngevlog Kawah Ijen, they aware well about Kawah Ijen. Jadi ketika ditanya tentang Kawah Ijen, they are aware gitu, paham banget gitu. understand it, the content.
Kak Nolik, Ben, and Daniel. Yeah, we have to put it in here because not all the teacher are join us to, and it will be there. So we would like we hope that all the teacher will understand as we discuss it today. There must be right idon in here. This part, there must be that the student are able to answer the questions. Whether they are able to answer the question, they do not able to answer the question, or maybe they are just so about answering the question and they cannot answer the question. We must put here because this is connected with the contents.
Content.
So what will be the sentences? What will be the good sentence to make the same understanding with all the teacher? Kita harus masukkan bagian dari juri bertanya or the student asking the question in here.
Mastery ya boleh, penguasaan ya.
Mastering the same with
knowledgeable.
Ya, kita mau masukkan pertanyaan gitu ya. That they are able to answer the questions. We give some information in here. Knowledgeable, okay. Mastering, okay. But there must be a statement that in here they are able to answer the question. How? What do you think, Bapak Ibu? Harus kita masukkan di sini ya. Knowledgeable and can answer all the questions.
I think that mastery and knowledgeable, I think it is the same. If student can answer the question, of course, it includes the category. I think like that, Holly.
Yeah, but the as I told you, not all the teacher join now. We have the same understanding in here because we are here and we are discussing. How about the other teacher? Because they will also become the EJU. When they read this, they really understand without our explanation. Iya kan? Jadi ketika membaca ini, mereka mengerti. Oh ya, berarti nanti ketika saya beri pertanyaan atau ada pertanyaan, dia bisa menjawab dengan betul. I will give 3 points, like that.
Maybe we can share the explanations through WhatsApp group, ma'am, aside from this assessment form.
Okay, yes, right. We will share this to all the teacher with how about student have a good comprehension of the topic they have presented. That's too long. The question is only 2 ya. Pertanyaan nanti kita batasi, pertanyaannya hanya 2. There must be 2 questions only. Pertanyaannya 2 saja, Bapak Ibu ya. Boleh dari EJU, boleh dari siswa. Observer. Tapi tidak boleh dari the same school, yang siswa dari sekolah yang sama tidak boleh bertanya. Oke, kita matangkan dulu kalimatnya, the sentences. Kita matangkan kalimatnya supaya mudah dipahami. Pak Febri, any idea, Pak Febri, Bu Eli, and all the other teachers?
Ma'am?
Yes, Bu Novita?
Yes, how about if the first is knowledgeable and students can answer the questions correctly.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah.
Knowledgeable and
students can answer the questions correctly.
Correctly, okay. Yeah. I think so. And answer the questions correctly.
Correctly. Good. Yes.
I think this is very clear. If like this, it will be very clear.
Yeah. If they can answer the 2 questions correctly, they will get 3 points.
Okay.
Yeah.
The
The second one.
Two.
How about aware of the subject and answer the question? Apa ya?
Some of the yeah, they can answer some of the questions.
Yes. Yes, that's right.
All.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Aware okay, of the subject.
Can you repeat once more time?
Yeah, Bu
Novita. Okay. Aware of the subject and answer some question. Some question correctly.
And answer on and answer. Oh yeah, if there is some in that point, we must add all the question correctly.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
For okay. For number one, for
3 points, knowledgeable and answer all the question. Is it so?
Yes, yes ma'am. Yes, that's right. That's what I mean.
Some of the questions.
Fabri, questions for Fabri.
Yes.
Questions.
Questions. Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Little understanding of the subject and cannot answer the questions.
Yeah.
Sangat mungkin Bapak Ibu dia nggak bisa jawab pertanyaan itu sangat mungkin. Yeah.
Yeah.
Little understanding of the subject and
cannot answer
the questions. Okay, nice. Yeah. This is when we are discussing together, then everything will be easy
and clearly, ma'am.
Yeah, easy and clear and clearly.
Questions? Oh yeah.
Cannot answer the questions.
S Bapak minus S Bapak. Questions.
Maybe they cannot answer. Okay, good. Wow, well done, Pak Febri. So how many? Yeah, this is we skip some. Make it easy for the AJU then. Okay, Bu Arista, no problem. But we have to take the picture first. Bu Eli, don't forget us the technician there.
Oh yeah.
We have to take the picture before our friend
Mas left. Mas Muir. Yeah, Mas.
Mas Muir, thank you very much. You are very helpful person, Mas yeah. Muir. We have so many picture from you yesterday.
You always stand by me, ma'am.
Yeah, very nice. Okay.
Iya, Mas. Iya dong. Dengan wajah yang wow, Mas. Senyum semua.
Screen. Yeah. Okay, Mas Muid, kawan Mas Muid. Bisa ditampilkan tadi assessment-nya Pak Febri. So, there is bisa ya Mas Muid ya, ada assessment-nya terlihat, kemudian wajah kita juga yang guru-guru yang semangat ini kelihatan juga bisa Mas Muid. Oke, okay. Keren. Oke. Okay. Thank you so much.
kasih Mas.
Now, Bu Eli, what will be next? Pak Febri, thank you very much. You have made about the assessment, and of course, you after this, you have to share to all the teacher in Seaborn, yes, and also
welcome,
to all the schools.
Okay.
Next, what is that, Bu Eli?
Ma'am, I have a question. Is there any list for the adjudicators?
We will discuss it now.
Okay. Yeah.
We will discuss it now.
Okay.
Okay. The teacher, I mean the school,
mm-mm,
the student who present, I mean become the participants, the EJU will come from the other schools. That's the rule. Jadi ketika sekolahnya tampil tidak boleh dinilai sendiri. That's the rule. This is, yes, only the rule. Today we will discuss together who will be the EJU for the next meeting. We have a, yes, look. We have a look together.
Okay. For the next meeting. So for Tuesday, the 9th of February.
Yeah. I recommend from SMA Alfata. It will be Bu Lisa.
SMA.
She has so many experience about how to be an EJU.
Yes.
And then
SMA Alfata.
Yeah. And SMA 1, we will discuss whether Bu Nawati or Bu Nona. Mm-hmm. And now choose for SMK. There will be, oh sorry, maybe the EJU is 3 is enough, I guess.
3 schools.
3 schools.
Only one adjudicator.
Sorry?
Three school. From three school, we have 3 adjudicators.
Yes.
So each institution will send one adjudicator.
Oh, yeah. 1 EJU, 2 EJU, and 3 EJU. There must be like that. What do you think? This is too much?
If we have one institution with 1 EJU.
No, I mean like this. The EJU will assess all the group which will present. So let's have a look. The school, the students, the school, the schedule here. Vocational school from Pakem, and then SMA, yeah, and City Bondo. They told me that they cannot perform next meeting. That's okay. It cannot change for the other schedule, because give the opportunity for the other school when they have some activity, they need another time. No, we will not do that. It will broken the system. It will broken the schedule that we have already made.
Yeah, of course.
Pak Ibu, kami Yeah, sorry. Yes, Bu Ellie. Hello, Bu Ellie. Bu Ellie. Ya gini Bapak Ibu, kalau karena saya gratisan ini jadi keluar masuk. Bu Eli, gimana?
Lebih baik pakai Google Meet kalau sama-sama gratisan.
Iya, kalau kemarin saya pakai Google Meet ya lancar, enak gitu, nggak keluar masuk. Ya mungkin nanti next meeting kalau kita meeting lebih baik pakai Google Meet ya Bu Eli ya.
Iya, lebih baik pakai Google Meet.
Iya, gimana? Jurinya kita putuskan berapa? How many EJU that we will choose? Two is enough or three? Gimana Bapak Ibu, jurinya dua atau tiga?
Harus ada cadangan, Bolif. Takutnya ada halangan.
Oke. Kalau ada halangan, menyampaikan sebelumnya ya. Menyampaikan sebelumnya, jadi bisa langsung diganti gitu ya, teman-teman ya. Oke. Okay. So, how many? Two or three?
Three is enough. Three.
Jadi komparasi nilainya bisa enak gitu ya. Pak Febri ini yang master yang membuat form. Pak Febri, where is Pak Febri? Berarti nanti langsung kita jumlahkan jumlah nilainya itu langsung dari juri, dari nggak usah dikasih juri satu dua, nggak apa-apa Bu Elia. It is okay. Then we mix together, we calculate, and then there will be the mark there for each schools. Gitu ya. Oke, okay, jurinya sekarang kita putuskan dari ini. SMA 1, SMA Alfata, Bu Lisa. Kemudian from SMK, silakan Bu Eli. I don't have the recommendation for SMK. You know better than me about the EJU from SMK. You choose it.
SMA 2 from government school.
SMA 2 SMK. Oke. SMA 2. So Bu Nona, for today, for the next meeting you will be the EJU.
Okay, Bu Nona, I agree.
Bu Lisa, and one from SMK. Bu Eli, choose SMK. SMA-nya, SMK-nya siapa? Bu Eli, Pak Febri, you choose it. Bu Eli. Bu Eli, can you hear my voice, Bu Eli?
Yes, ma'am. Sorry.
Okay. Choose SMK, Bu Eli. Choose one SMK of the EJU.
Yeah. SMK one will be fine.
Okay. Okay, so this is the EJU for the next performance. SMA Alfata, SMA 2 Bondowoso, that's Bu Nona. Next when there is SMA Bondowoso will be Bu Nawati. I'm not allowed to be the EJU. The other teacher will do that. From SMK 1, Vocational School 1, right, Bu Eli? Pak Febri, you are not allowed to be the EJU because your school will performing. Will perform that.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, ma'am, we've got three school as the educators and one school, one institution with one educator.
Yes.
No. The three EJU will sit together. And each of them will give the mark. Masing-masing jurinya menilai.
Yeah.
And then we calculate together. Bisa begitu ya Pak Febri in the Google form. So there is the mark from Bu Lisa, for example. Bu Lisa give 10, and then Bu Nona give 9, and then Bu Eli give 7, and then we combine together. Bisa ya Bapak? Standarnya sudah sama, because Pak Febri have made the instruments. Tentu sama, karena instrumennya sudah dibuat oleh Pak Febri. Itu Bapak Ibu ya?
for the future of my country.
Okay. Pak Febri, nanti cara jumlahkannya gimana ya Pak Febri, biar cepat Pak Febri?
So important
how to calculate all the mark.
The future. Because lot of
Pak Febri, unmute your microphone, Pak Febri.
Sorry.
Yeah.
And other.
I tried last night to automatically calculate, but I have problem with that. I'm facing difficulty, but all the data is recorded on the spreadsheet. So every teacher, who gives their assessment
will be recorded as a spreadsheet.
Wait a minute, Bapak. May I interrupt you, Bapak? Ini ada suara-suara lain. Ini jadi suara Pak Nur. Pak Nur, unmute please.
Okay.
Please mute your microphone, Pak Nur. Okay. Yeah. Please go on.
Okay. I repeat once again. I tried last night to calculate automatically, but I'm facing a problem. But all the data that educator give the assessment have recorded by spreadsheet. It means that I have to count it manually. I don't know the way how to calculate automatically.
Yeah, Pak Febri, good idea. If it cannot be automatically calculated, then you have to write it on. Sorry, then you have another work to make it then.
Yes. Okay.
That's good.
I think I can do it.
Nice. Thank you, Pak Febri. What else, Bu Eli?
I think it's enough, ma'am. Maybe. Is there any question, Bapak Ibu, from all participants attend this meeting today? Is there any question?
It is quiet clear, Bu Eli. Well, thank you so much, Bu Eli, Pak Febri, and all the teachers. Some teacher comes and some teacher out because you're using this Zoom. Gratis biasa kan begitu ya Bapak Ibu. That's okay Bu Eli. That's okay. Can you help me Bu Eli? Yes, Bu Sri.
For making the video, wearing casual clothes or uniform?
Casual. Oh yeah, one more thing I forget. I will share the flyer. So remember, when they present about telling story, there must be in a groups. The group consists of 3 students. Okay, ini untuk melatih anak-anak kita berani. Jadi they always in a groups, 3 students. Okay, so the teacher, you as the teacher, we as the teacher will divide it because we know there's our student ability. For example, A itu bagian openingnya, ini bagian kontennya, ini dia bagian closingnya. Jadi ketika presentasi selalu bertiga. Kemudian use flyer. I will share the flyer. Flyer itu anak-anak pinter banget. Misalnya mereka memilih tourist promotion, maka di situ SMA 1 Pujer ready with tourist promotion. Ada judulnya begitu. Vocational School Klabang with culinary. Dengan mereka pasti keren-keren kok anak-anak kalau membuat flyer. I will give the example. Nanti flyer, contoh flyer SMK dari Jawa Barat, I will send to the group that the student will see it. They will be able to make it more creative. Pasti anak-anak setelah melihat contoh bisa menghasilkan lebih bagus. I think the cloth is up to you. No problem. Casual. Give our students freedoms to choose the clothes. Mau pakai seragam boleh, pakai alma mater boleh, pakai baju bebas boleh, no problem. Yang penting bebas rapi.
With mask.
Oh, in performing, when they make a vlog outside, they know whether it is dangerous or not. Anak-anak tuh kan tahu ya bahaya atau tidak, Bapak Ibu. Ketika membuat vlog, there are so many people, I think they use mask. Like Noval, when Noval make the vlog in alun-alun, it is very dangerous. That is why he's still using a mask. But when the students talk in front of their house and they think it is not dangerous, maybe they can open their mask.
Okay.
I think it's very conditional, right? Conditional sekali, Bapak Ibu, dilihat situasi dan kondisinya ya.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's all. Thank you so much, Bapak Bu Eli, closing this. Thank you so much. Keep on your spirit because this is our way, this is our fields, this is our competence, to improve our competence, to improve our students' competence, and we just one thing that whatever we do, Allah will note this is our will be very useful knowledge, and it will be in the hereafter when we sleep, then our students are able to speak English because we teach them. This becomes sodako jariah for us. So keep on this because this is our competence and our ibadah, I think. Tidak boleh melemah, Bapak Ibu, apapun kondisi murid kita. I think that's all from me. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you, Ibu Olive, Pak Febri, and all teachers for your contribution in our discussion today about the assessment of speaking skill. Let me close the meeting. Thank you so much. Stay safe, stay healthy, and get spirit. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you so much. Bye-bye all. Bu Eli, you have to write it down.